Assalamu alaikum. We all have friends. We consider them close to us. We share with them some secrets. We spend time with them. We allow them to have an influence upon us, or they allow us to have a certain level of influence upon them. But my brothers and sisters, Allah says,
الْأَخِلَّاءُ يَوْمَئِذٍ بَعْضُهُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌ إِلَّا الْمُتَّقِينَ.
The bosom buddies, the closest of friends. You know, أَخِلَّاء is the plural of خَلِيل. And خَلِيل is from خُلَّة. The highest level of friendship. This is why Allah says,
وَاتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ إِبْرَاهِيمَ خَلِيلًا.
Allah has taken Ibrahim alayhi salam as a khalil, as a close friend. And even Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah took him as a close friend. So Allah says, as for the people, they're close friends. There will be close friends, very close friends. On the day of judgment, they will be enemies of one another. Enemies of one another. Except for those who had developed a relationship with Allah. Al-Muttaqeen, they are the ones who were conscious of Allah. So from this I learned that my friends on earth, any one of them who diverts me from the remembrance of Allah or diverts me from the path of the Messenger and makes me forget about the fact that I have to meet with my Maker one day and I have to be upon my best behavior at all times, and I have to fulfill my obligations of worshiping none other than Allah and following the path of the Messenger, and I have to make sure that I've stayed away from prohibitions. A friend is he or she who guides you away from that which is sinful, considered sinful by Allah's instruction. And a friend is he or she who guides you towards that which is a duty unto Allah. When I'm doing something bad, they will remind me. When I'm doing something good, they will encourage me and they will join me in that good. Those are true friends. The rest, we need to look into whether that friendship is actually true. Is it a friendship that is going to take you to your ultimate goal, which is paradise? Is it going to take you to your ultimate eternal success, or is it just a temporary pleasure? Those who take you to places that would earn the displeasure of Allah, you need to be the better friend by reminding them not to go there, or by helping them abstain. Remember to use your time constructively. With your friends, remind them. Don't feel bad when you are reminded to do the right thing. But people only go to bad places and do bad things in your company and with you, they cannot be considered true friends. They might be acquaintances, but they're making you head in the wrong direction. There will be severe enmity on the day of judgment between you guys. And this is why we would say, just a reminder, go back, draw up a list of your friends. If you want to make a mental note of them, ask yourself each one, How is our relationship and where do they take us? You know, how does this friendship help me gain closeness to Allah? So there are some who may not help you gain closeness to Allah, but they won't take you further away either. It's okay, but you've benefited not much. Perhaps you want to benefit those. There are some who would drift you away from Allah. Perhaps you want to keep away from them, because if you cannot have an impact upon them to bring them towards Allah and they're drifting you away, then you're at a loss to have those friends. Even if you were to earn something through them, but it's not good enough to lose your eternal hereafter just for the benefit of a temporary current life. And similarly, if you were being drawn towards Allah by the company that you have, wow, well done, mashallah, tabarakallah. Those are good people. That's good company. And bi-ithnillah, by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will achieve a lot. So true friends are those who would bring you closer to Allah, who would remind you to become better, not to abandon your duties unto Allah. Sometimes we develop a circle of friends and our dress code changes, becoming that which we know is distancing us from Allah. If that's the case, we need to do better, my brothers, my sisters. And this is not just advice for sisters. You know, usually when we just mention dress code, a lot of the men think it's just for the women. No, it's for you as well. We need to dress in a beautiful way. We need to make sure we carry ourselves in a lovely way. How you manage your gaze is part of your dress code. It's part of your character and conduct in Islam. So this is beautiful. Let's try our best to remember never to allow the company we keep to make us drift away from the relation or from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, such that the relationship becomes weaker. Maybe we abandon prayer. Maybe we start up some bad habits, intoxicants and drugs and whatever else, the nightlife to a certain degree. And perhaps we might forget to read the Quran. We might stop praying. We might stop fasting. We might start maybe questioning things in a bad way. It's good to question in order to learn. But subhanAllah, when a person is just defying, belief is something that's within you that you need to develop. And sometimes when you're in the wrong company, they would shake that belief. I'd rather be in company that would actually help me build that belief than being on the other side. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless every one of us and grant us goodness. Before I go, I'm not saying be bad to those who might not be as religious as you are, or I'm not saying be hurtful, harmful, or abusive to those or towards those who might not even have a proper relationship with Allah. But all I'm saying is be concerned about yourself. Worry about yourself and make sure that you are not being negatively affected by the crowd around you. May Allah bless you all. أقول قولي هذا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.